Steph, you at the end of the game saw, you know, the same two or three defenders. Can you talk about, like, what that was like all year, seeing a full season of the concentrated defense and maybe how that impacted your season?
Kept me sharp because I played well. Every game, knowing that you're going to get thrown the kitchen sink at you, it's fun. It's exhausting, but it's fun.
With the Golden State Warriors last season missing the entire playoffs, there's been a lot of offseason rumors about this team. The Warriors are ready to build another championship run around their franchise player Stephen Curry. Klay Thompson's returning from an ACL injury and an Achilles injury. Draymond Green is still amazing on both ends, just good at everything but scoring. And there are some really big moves that this Golden State Warriors team has to decide to just give. And like we've just shown that with this weird season, this team just isn't good enough to make even the playoffs. And there has to be some big moves. And they have a lot of assets. They have the second overall pick, James Wiseman. They have the 7th pick in this draft and the 14th pick, along with a couple future picks that they can package in a trade to help Steph right now. And there's been, like I said, a lot of rumors for what they should do. And today we're going to be looking at, what the Golden State Warriors and why they're ready to make another championship run. And they're ready to make a blockbuster move to pair up Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, and make a really good team. Now, a lot of people have seen this rumor, but with them willing to be able to trade Wiseman and picks, it's also noted that if they trade for a guy with at least $25 million or over $20 million contract, person who makes that much, they need to throw in Draymond Green or Andrew Wiggins. That can be, or we'll talk about them later, but basically anyone they want is gonna be making over $25 million, over $30 million, and most likely on a max contract. And it's gonna be tough because Wiggins, Wiseman, those picks, that's a lot of value. I would say that Wiggins kind of is a negative asset because his contract is just so big for the production he's providing, but he's still a good player on this Warriors team on both ends. Now, John Hollinger of The Athletic stated that they're willing to trade any value that won't help Steph Curry right now. And the first person to watch is Pascal Siakam. Now, Pascal is still a really good player and just came off a season averaging 21 points, 7 rebounds, and 5 assists. And the year before, made the All-NBA second team. Now, he hasn't been as good as that All-NBA second team, but he's still a really good player. And with the Raptors going in the rebuild, having the 4th pick, having OG Anunoby, Malachi Flynn, some young assets, they might go for a rebuild, and it might be a totally new era. Pascal, I think, is very realistic because maybe they want to go on a different direction with him. And I think that with this Warriors team, he can defend. And he shot 30% from 3 in the regular season this season. But the season before, he shot 36%. And I think that with him getting easy looks from Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, and good passes from Draymond Green, I think he can get a lot of open shots and knock them down consistently. His defense is good on the perimeter and interior, and we know that he can be an All-NBA second team guy. His shooting can fluctuate sometimes, but I think he would be a really good fit. Now, do you want Pascal to play the 5? Maybe not. I mean, maybe you move Draymond to the 3. You go like a Curry, Klay, Draymond, Pascal, and then like a center like Kevon Looney or James. Oh, they trade James Wiseman probably, but it's going to be really interesting. I do like the fit a lot. And if they can get him, I think that's a really good deal. Now, someone maybe not as realistic is Bradley Beal. If Beal is disgruntled in Washington and wants a trade, the Warriors can throw a really good package with just like having so many assets. 2 lottery picks is really good, and a a former second overall pick is a lot of value, and that's a good way to build your franchise, and that just isn't needed for this Warriors team that wants to compete. Beal on the Warriors would be really good. Now, you would have to move Klay to the 3, and the defense might be a bit of a problem, but that scoring of Curry and Beal, the top 2 scoring leaders, that would be so good as a 3-level scorer, and the spacing would be so good, even if they had Draymond, and yeah. But maybe they can go for, this is probably the most unrealistic, but what about Damian Lillard? You would probably think that there are some better packages than Wiseman, those 2 lottery picks and Wiseman, but it's still an enticing package. Dame and Curry would be so fun to watch, and yes, the defense might not be the best, but just splashing 3-pointers, running off of screens, being able to shoot from the logo, that would be must-see TV. But that's not all in Portland. CJ McCollum is also an option. He is a 3-level scorer and is so calm and collective when scoring. He has experience as a second option, but we've seen the shortcomings of Damian Lillard and CJ McCollum. The best they made is the conference finals where they lost to the Warriors, but they just have basically been a first round exit recently, and I don't know if just even with Curry replacing Dame, I don't think that ceiling is as high as some people think, and mainly because of the defense. And maybe this is and I think that just CJ, he's a good player, but to fit this Warriors team that already has Steph Curry, who isn't the best defender, he's an average defender, but not the best, I don't think he would be a good fit, and their offense can't compromise for that amount of defense. Now, maybe the biggest far-fetch, maybe the biggest reach, is Ben Simmons. Now, first, the spacing of Draymond and Ben Simmons would be so bad with basically them breaking every shot or Ben not shooting them. But a package around Wiggins, the 7th pick and maybe the 14th pick, that can be really enticing. The 76ers get a better shooter than Ben, and still an above average defender, while also picking up some picks for a future trade or to help their shooting alongside Joel Embiid. But I'm not sure if Wiggins would be really good with the 76ers. I personally think that he excels in the Warriors culture, and as we saw in like a toxic culture in Minnesota, I'm not saying the 76ers culture is bad, but they have faced a lot of shortcomings, but I think that Wiggins, I think he just fits best in the Warriors, and I'm not sure how he would perform with the 76ers, but I still think he can be good. And I just think that for both sides, it's interesting, but I don't know if it's going to happen. Running Ben Simmons may seem weird, but if you start to think about it, what if you ran Ben Simmons at center? And I think that would be really interesting. He doesn't have to space the floor as a center. And the Warriors have run Kevon Looney, Andrew Bogut at the 5. And the spacing wasn't that bad. Though I would say that Kelly Oubre and Kevin Durant, I would say I would say it's close, but definitely close. But that spacing isn't as good. But it does improve their defense, their playmaking. But their shooting would be suspect. I do think that Ben, as just leading up the ball, being able to defend all 5 positions, and as a center, would be really good. He just doesn't fit with Philly with Joel Embiid being, he's their franchise guy. Now maybe, like I said, for Dame, maybe the Sixers can get a better package of like CJ McCollum or D'Angelo Russell, but definitely an interesting offer. So all in all, the Warriors are ready to make a move. They have a team that is good, but not good enough to be a championship team. And with the return of Klay Thompson, the MVP level play of Stephen Curry, the defensive player of the year play from Draymond Green, and some other exciting young role players in Juan Toscano-Anderson, Jordan Poole, Damian Lee, I think this team has a future, but I still think that there's a couple stars away. Maybe that could be one star, like the people are talking about, Pascal, Dame, CJ, Ben, but it's going to be interesting. I do like that this Warriors franchise has shown competency. They drafted Curry. Yes. They made the decision not to trade away Curry when he had bad ankles. They drafted Draymond in the 2nd round. Klay, they believed it. They didn't trade Klay for Kevin Love. And they've shown that they know what the correct moves are. And with Curry's prime dwindling away, I think he's going to be good for really good, but at an MVP level, it might only be for a couple years. And but still, I still think at 40 he can still hoop because of his shooting. But this team needs another, just more talent. And with Stephen Curry's free agency looming in 2022, it's kind of scary. And I saw a report that like the GM is okay with Curry leaving because of everything he has done. Of course, you don't want that, but they have to do whatever they can to keep Stephen Curry, and that can be trading their whole future. But if you can get a championship, it's all worth it. So that being said, comment down below, do you think the Warriors should make a blockbuster move? And if they should, who they should get? Make sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and I'll see you all next time.